Hey folks, welcome to another Triple T Thursday. For those just joining us, that's Tools, Tips, and Talk, where we'll discuss info for the knife maker. So I've decided to re-record my beginner series playlist, starting from the very first video on how to get started, and that's what you're watching. I've decided to break this video up into two. Whether you're going to start with stock removal, meaning you're just going to start with a piece of steel and cut the knife out, or whether you want to forge it, because not everybody wants to do forging. Some people just want to start with stock removal. So this video is going to be all about starting with stock removal, meaning you're just going to start with either a piece of steel like this or maybe a blank. And what tools do you need? What kind of steels to select? Everything you need to get started. Despite what Fortune Fire has shown people, 90% of knife making occurs after you get the profile done. Whether you're forging it or you're cutting it out, 90% of the work starts now. So this is why I think starting at stock removal is a great idea in knife making, because most of the hard work is the grinding and the finishing work. So let's first talk about steel. And if you're watching this and you're a beginner, you may not know the different kinds of steels, what steels to stay away from, what steels to start with. We're going to be talking about carbon steels. Carbon steels are the easier to work with. The definition between a carbon steel and a stainless steel is the amount of chromium in it. So we're going to stay away from steels that have chromium, because those require a very special heat treat with equipment you probably don't have, like a kiln. So we're going to stick to carbon steels and relatively easy carbon steels to heat treat. The two I suggest are 5160, which is normally what you would find in, say, a leaf spring in a car, normally. Sometimes there are other steels, but most likely they are 5160. Most large coil springs are also 5160. So it's the one steel that I would say it's okay to use reclaimed steel. I don't normally advise anyone use mystery steel when they're starting out, because you just don't know how to heat treat it. And why not take that element of mystery out of it so you can be successful? The number one reason people get out of this hobby is just they get discouraged. They don't have success. I want you to have the most amount of success at the beginning so you can get into it and get interested. So for steels, I suggest 5160 or 1080. 1080 is a U.S. Designation where the 10, I don't know how they came up with 10, but the 10 denotes a 10 series steel, and the last two digits represent the carbon content as a fraction of a percentage. So 1080 would have approximately 0.8% carbon, and carbon is what helps us harden the steel. So that's a very easy steel to work with. We'll talk about heat treating in a future video, but those two steels are very easy to heat treat. 5160, you can actually heat treat very well with canola oil, which is why I kind of put that in the first category. It's easy to work with, it's easy to heat treat, so that's one of the ones I suggest. But if you're going to just order steel, 1080 is fine. So either of those. Where are you going to get steel? So if you're, we're talking about stock removal here, so you're gonna be ordering steel in bars, like this. This is just a piece of, I'm not sure, I don't remember what this is, I really should mark on it. But this is a piece of steel that's 3/16 thick, inch and a half, and this is probably 8 or 10 inches of steel. So it'll be a smallish knife. Some reputable dealers, of course, I always recommend Maritime Knife Supply because they are a sponsor of the show, but they're also an excellent place to get all things for knife making. So link to them is down in the video description. There's also a bunch of others, Jantz Supply, Pops Knife Supply, New Jersey Steel Baron. There's a bunch of places. I'll put some links down in the description as well. Of course, I do recommend Maritime Knife Supply. So next, what tools are you gonna need? So I'm gonna divide this into two categories. First, the minimalist version of, you know, I don't want to really spend much money at all. What basic tools can I get by with? And then what I would consider the normal list of tools if you do want to spend a little money. So let's look at the list. So first off, you're going to need some way to cut the steel. The easiest way is an angle grinder. It's also the cheapest way. Not the cleanest way. It generates a bunch of dirt and stuff, smoke. So angle grinder can be, you'll want to upgrade to something else later on, like a portaband. But you definitely will need an angle grinder. Next, you're going to need a way to put in the bevel. The old-time way is just to use files. And this is a viable approach. It's going to take you a while. It's going to take you some manual effort, but you can put bevels in a knife with files, and you can put them in pretty accurately even. So don't be afraid to try the old way, and use some files. For all tools, I have links down in the video description of what tools I use and links to where to get them. These are Amazon affiliate links, so the channel gets a little kickback. No cost to you. So go down and look at my Amazon store in the video description. So angle grinder, files. The next thing you're gonna need is some kind of forge. You're gonna need to heat treat these knives. Yes, you can send knives out for heat treat, but this is a critical step that you're gonna need to learn. If you wanna get into this, forges are not expensive. You can get a forge for under $100 now. So I recommend you get one anyway. Get a cheap forge just for heat treating. Maybe it's not something you're gonna be making Damascus in later, you'll probably upgrade, but get a cheap forge that you can do some heat treating in. You're gonna need some quench oil. And if you start with 5160, you can just use canola oil you buy at the grocery store. If you use 1080, it really doesn't like canola oil. You really need an engineered quench oil like Parks 50. There's links down in the video description of where you can get Parks 50. And that will give you better results for 1080. So that will kind of get you the knife done, but then you need to worry about some wood for the handles. For your first knife, go to your big box store, Lowe's, Home Depot, whatever it is, and just get some wood in, either samples, wood flooring samples work sometimes. Don't get a softwood, get a hardwood, and just play with it. Again, your first knife is probably not something you're going to sell. You'll probably look back on it and think, yeah, it wasn't so great at the time. It was great at the time, wasn't so great later. So you probably don't want to spend a ton of money on it. So get some kind of wood. You're going to need some pin material. So whether you buy some just steel rod, or you get brass rod, or you can even get G10 pins. Obviously the cheapest of those is going to be just steel rod. You can get that at a big box store. You're going to need some epoxy, some two-part epoxy. Again, all of this, link down in the description, get yourself some two-part epoxy. That's what you're going to be putting your scales on with. And obviously you're going to need some kind of way to drill holes, and you're going to need drill bits. So whether it's a hand drill, not ideal, obviously better is a drill press, but you're going to need something to drill some holes. That will get you the basics. Then lastly, you're going to need some way to shape that handle, take the sharp corners off. You're going to need sandpaper. You have files as well at your disposal, so you're going to need a way to shape things. So that will get you the basics. Probably for a couple hundred bucks, you'll get into the craft here. So that's the minimalist version. The things that I would change for kind of the normal version would be changing from files to some kind of grinder, like a 1x30 grinder, which is kind of the entry level that most people use. Maybe a 2x48 if you can find one. I would stay away from the wider belts, like 3 or 4 inch belts. They're very hard to contour some shapes of knives. You will probably, I started with a 4 inch wide belt. You will regret it. You're gonna wanna go with this, no more than a 2 inch belt. So a 1x30 or a 2x48 or something like that, you're gonna need some kind of grinder to put those bevels in. It'll just save you so much time over files. Later on, you know, most professional knife makers will move up to a 2x72. The length of the belt just gives you more abrasive. It doesn't wear out as fast. A good 2x72 is going to be variable speed. It's going to have more torque. Lots of reasons you're eventually going to want to go to one of those. Maybe you want to start with one. Maybe not. But most people won't start with a 2x72. Maybe for your first knife, if you got some money, you want to go with a little more exotic woods. I always recommend Bell Forest products for exotic wood, like African blackwood, zebra wood, basically any kind of wood that you can think of that you want to use, ironwood, whatever. They have it in great little bundles. You can buy a bundle of wood from them that has 9 different types of wood in 1.5 by 1.5 by 12 inch blocks, 9 of those for about $65. So it's a great buy, something that, you know, is really a really good value. For the normal kind of purchase list, I would add a port-a-band to that. A port-a-band is a small metal cutting bandsaw, something that you can do the profile of a knife on without having to use an angle grinder. Obviously, they're a little more expensive, and you normally put these on an aftermarket table because they're meant, it's actually a handsaw, but everyone puts these on a table so that you can use them as kind of like a little stand-up table saw. So those you can also do your handles, you can cut your handle scales on. So that's what you want to get eventually. Also, you can go to the engineered quench oil, the 1080 quench oil, which is about $45 a gallon. So there's some extra cost there. Again, you pick what you want to do, whether you want the minimalist or kind of the normal version of the tools. Another tool you might consider upgrading is to a drill press from a hand drill. This will help you drill straight holes that are 90 degrees because you're going to be using a table. So an important tool, you can get a drill press, a quality drill press for $80. So kind of no reason not to consider getting a drill press. It'll help you in any kind of tooling you want to do. Later on in this series, we'll be doing step-by-step videos on making your first knife, whether you're going to start from forging or stock removal, how to do bevels, how to do grinds, how to do pins, all of that stuff we're going to be going through in a step-by-step manner. We will do videos on heat treating, what it means to heat treat a knife. Before that, we'll go through knife steels. What are the different kinds of knife steels you might consider in the future? When should you change knife steels? All of that information will be coming in this series. So that's all we're going to cover in this first intro video. Stay tuned in the rest of this series. We're going to be building a knife that looks something like this. Stay tuned. Eventually, hopefully, you'll be able to make something like this. Thanks for watching, folks. Stay tuned for future episodes in this series. We'll see you on the next one.